Today's episode is all about my goals for 2019, so I thought it would be metaphorically appropriate for me to be out here at the Redmond High School soccer field to score my very first goal of the year. So I thought it would be metaphorically appropriate for me to be out here at the Redmond High School soccer field to score my very first goal of the year. So I thought it would be metaphorically appropriate for me to... So I thought it would be metaphorically appropriate for me to be out here at the Redmond High School soccer field to score my very first one.
Nope.
That was the wrong line. So I thought it would be metaphorically appropriate for me to be out here at the Redmond High School soccer field to score my very first goal of the year. In order to get somewhere, you have to know where it is you want to go. So I'm going to get 2019 rolling by talking about my goals. A part of me thinks it might be better to do it in a different order, where first I gather all the information about exactly what I'm currently made of and what I'm capable of. But I've also spent the past 8 years working on that information, so I think at this point I do know enough about my body composition and my abilities at the gym to lay out my basic goals and then get that data later and do the precise math for reaching my goals in time. So we'll go ahead and do it in that order. My overall broad goal is to create a better body, inside and outside, one that functions well inside, where the heart and the lungs and the muscles and any other related aspects of it all do what they're supposed to, and they do it in a very healthy way, enabling me to be an active parent for my children and to be a long-lived person for the benefit of my entire family, my wife and my kids. And so that I'm not spending a lot of time in the doctor's office and later in life ingesting a lot of medication because things have gone wrong. I want to see, you know, how long can I, in a responsible and healthy way, maintain this body? And yes, to be honest about it, I would like to create what I consider to be a great-looking exterior as well. Not to be vain or narcissistic about it, I don't ever want to become that guy who's got a great body and knows it and is constantly strutting around showing off and practically expecting people to idolize him. I want to be comfortable in my body and even confident in it. I've been the skinny teen and the overweight adult. I've never really been in between and I haven't been comfortable with my physical condition. I'm over some of the worst of it. I think back to a time in college that I didn't have time to put it in the first episode, but several of my dorm mates all decided one night to go swimming at the campus pool, and I went along thinking, great idea. But then we got to the locker room, and I noticed a sign on the wall leading into the showers that said, everyone must take a naked shower before going in the pool for the purpose of cleaning off and, you know, not overburdening the chlorine in the pool. And I couldn't do it. As everyone else was getting ready, I was so shy about that and so reserved and so self-conscious about anybody seeing this and seeing all of me, that I just, once they were looking the other way, I actually just left the locker room and went back to my dorm. I'm better than that now. I've been to a beach down in California within the past 3 years, but I think it was a good 20 years, maybe 15, before I even went to our local community pool with my wife and kids, because I did reach a point when I was 280 pounds. I didn't even like seeing myself in the mirror getting out of the shower or anything like that. I did not like what I had here. And I want to get completely over that. I really do. And so I know there are more important things in life than building a great body. And I have a good life. I have one that I very much enjoy. I would just like to add a smoking body to it. That's the overall life goal, whether that takes 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 years from now, whether I can even achieve that before the natural aging process simply says, too late, I don't know. But let's take a look at 2019 then specifically. What do I want to accomplish this year? And my first goal is that I would like to, for the first time since becoming an adult, get my weight under 200 pounds. From 2008 to 2012, I did get my weight to go from 281 pounds to 211 pounds. So in the second half of 2012, it hit 211 pounds, but that was the lowest that it got, and then it bounced back up, and I haven't been that low ever since. I fought for it last year, 2018, and I went from about 253 pounds to what I am now, about 237 pounds. Obviously, I didn't fight hard enough because that is mathematically possible. So in 2019, to only have to drop 37 or 38 pounds should actually be quite achievable with even a minimal amount of focus and dedication. Obviously, I want to do that in a responsible way. I could get below 200 pounds by chopping off a couple of limbs, but that would not be the best way to do it. I want to get under 200 pounds by working with goal number 2, which is to get my body fat under 10%, just once. Just once. I know it's really hard to get it that low, and it's hard to keep it there. I'd love to see that number drop down to 10% just once. And if this is kind of a new subject to you and you're not quite sure what's being talked about here, I will explain that more in episode 3. But for now, that is goal number 2. Get my body fat down below 10% sometime this year. For my third goal, I have created a list over the past 8 years of exercises that I keep track of in terms of my abilities to do them. Some of them are key exercises for any serious weightlifter, and some are just ones that I really like, and I've put this list together, and I keep track of how well I perform each one anytime I do it at the gym. And somewhere around here, I have a list of my bests. What's my heaviest bench press I've ever done? What's my fastest mile I've ever run? And I think of almost 24 off the top of my head. I think it's about 24 items there. And my third goal then is to set a new personal best in each one of those in 2019. My fourth goal centers around the three kings of weightlifting exercises: the bench press, the deadlift, and the squat. And I will talk about those in upcoming episodes. But those three exercises are pretty central to anyone who is going to the gym to get stronger. And I have a goal of hitting 315 pounds on each of those. Why 315? Because that represents three 45-pound plates on either side of a standard weightlifting bar. And that's considered a milestone. Some people call it the 315 Club. And so I want to enter the 315 Club this year on all three of those lifts. And then, for the simple reason that it has not happened since junior high, I want to reach a point where I can perform one pull-up. Between a combination of gaining weight and losing strength in the relative muscles for doing a pull-up, I just haven't been able to do one for the longest time. And so I want to see if I can achieve that before 2019 comes to an end. For anyone who is a longtime friend or follower of my efforts, you will recognize all 5 of those goals from last year, and at least 4 of them from 2016. I hadn't yet taken up powerlifting in 2016, so I didn't have goal number 4 about hitting the 315 Club. But, last year I had those goals, and I didn't reach any of them. I got stronger and healthier for trying, but I didn't reach them, so we're going to make them the list for 2019. I've got some other ones that are more, I guess you'd say, for fun, or at least making gaining strength a fun endeavor. And the first one is an idea I came up with when an acquaintance of mine from college posted on Facebook that he had just finished his goal of jogging a mile in all 50 states before he turned 50. He was 48 when he started. I didn't even know he was doing this, and all of a sudden he was posting his achievement in completing it. And he's very much into running, so that was what he wanted to do with that. And I thought, what a cool idea. But I'm going to modify it just a little bit, and I'm going to see if I can do 50 push-ups in all 50 states by the time I turn 50. I've given myself more time than he did, partly because I apparently don't have the income he does. I cannot just up and cover all 50 states in our country in the next 2 years. So I've given myself over 6.5 years at this point to achieve that goal. I will, of course, keep you updated. Another goal in the form of a challenge comes to me from a friend of mine in Wales. He'll go by the name of Harry because that's his name, but I will leave the rest of him anonymous and just call him UK Harry. He and I have been online friends for all 8 years. We've never met yet. I would like to someday. Maybe I should make that a goal. It is kind of a goal, but I'm not putting it on my 2019 list. Anyway, point is, every year he offers up various challenges. He apparently has some spare cash lying about and wants to encourage and motivate me, and it works. And so this year he is repeating a challenge that he has done for the past 2 years, and that is for this year, it's called the 2019 Push-Ups Challenge. Basically, when the year starts, there is a pot of money available to me, award money, of $36.50. That represents a dime a day for 2019. And I am to start doing push-ups. And I am to tally them up as the days go by. And as soon as I hit 2019 push-ups, I get the pot of money. But he's taking out a dime for every day I don't reach it. So there's incentive to hurry through this and not just spread it out over all year. If I wait until December 31st, I get a dime. If I finish it tomorrow, at this point, I get $35.80 as I record this. So we'll see. Last year, I finished in May, I think, in part because I just let too many days go where I didn't even think about it. I got up and I lived my life and I went to bed and I went, oh, I didn't do any push-ups today. So this year I have a spreadsheet and I am ready to go. And even as I record this, I think I've already hit 100. So pushing forward, and we're going to see how much of Harry's money I can get very, very soon. For me, weightlifting needs to be fun. I am not one of these guys who finds raw thrill in simply the act of working out. I know some of these guys on Instagram and Twitter, and they just love going to the gym. I am somewhere in between the spectrum. I don't hate it, but it's not an addiction. I can go and I can get myself there and I'll have a pretty good time while I'm there, but I have to do things that make it fun. And one of them is creating this video series, getting out the camera and shooting and editing and putting it together like little miniature movies, 20-minute episodes for you. And so, you know, there's that. But I have a couple other things I'm doing. They're really just for fun. They're to make my adventure more enjoyable for me. And one of them is I want to see if I can get 12 guests into this video series during the 2019 episodes. And so I will be reaching out to local friends who are weightlifters and maybe people within Oregon. If, you know, I do have the ability and the budget to get to Portland and some outlying, maybe Seattle. I've met some people and made sort of online acquaintances through Instagram and Twitter and Facebook, and I'll see if I can bring them on. I've done that in the past in previous video endeavors, and I might bring some of those some of that footage in to just to help, you know, teach and spread some information. But they won't count toward that goal. I want to bring in 12 guests this year, where I meet them this year, we shoot the video this year, and we present it to you this year. So that averages one a month. We'll see what happens. And finally, I have a goal of attending the Mr. Olympia. What is it called? The bodybuilding competition or the Mr. Olympia? What's it called? It's a convention. It's a thing. It's a thing that happens in Las Vegas every September. And I've made some friends as far back as 2014 who I discovered go every year. And every year they keep saying, Brian, you should come down. And every year I keep pointing out I don't have the kind of job and income that allow me to just up and go down to Las Vegas and lose a lot of money on a hotel to meet them and a bunch of bodybuilders and gain the motivation and inspiration from that event. I know it will be motivating and inspiring whatever year I get there, and I'm going to make it a goal, a focus, to slowly set aside money to get there this year. We'll see how that one turns out. I should spend just a brief moment taking a look at some of the possible obstacles in my path, not as a way of creating excuses, but as a way of identifying and facing reality. You know, if you are doing hurdles in the Olympics, you look ahead and you see the hurdle and you calculate what it's going to take to get over it. And so, you know, there are hurdles in real life. And the first one that sticks out to me is the fact that I'm getting older. No, I didn't say I'm old. Somebody always says, "You're not old, Brian. You know, I'm 44. But I'm also not 20. If I had had this kind of motivation when I was 20, I'd be a beast by now. Oh, well. You know, I have to be a little more cautious at the gym than some people might need to be. And just because of the natural bodily functions, the processes, the way hormones do start to shut down as you get older, I'm going to have to try harder than other people to achieve what I want to achieve. That's just a reality. The other big obstacle is simply my life as a middle to low income family man. Not to reduce my wife and kids to mere obstacles in life, but just, you know, in relation to this goal, I do have to find a way to reach that goal without, you know, alienating my wife and kids. I want to be the husband and father that that they know and love. I've heard of bodybuilders. I've seen them posting online. You know, had to dump my girlfriend because she didn't like my going to the gym. I don't know if this guy was serious or bragging, but I read a post from one guy who said he got divorced because his wife was not happy with his becoming a professional size, you know, steroids and all. Competitive bodybuilder. That's not worth it to me. I would much rather end my life out of shape, but with a happy family, than have the perfect body and no one to love. So it's a matter of striking the balance and making sure that I find a way to achieve my goals that still enables me to be the man who goes out and works for the wife and family, brings home the money, pays the bills, and helps nurture them and just unite the whole family unit and keep it together in a happy and healthy way. So that is both the big picture of what I want to achieve with my health and fitness inside and outside, and the little picture of what I want to do in 2019 to get closer to that ultimate goal. And we'll see what happens in the upcoming episodes. I ended up with 80 seconds to spare in this video, so I'm going to share my first Passing It On segment, and that's where I share some little piece of information with you that I think will be helpful, especially for newcomers. And for this first one, since we were talking about goals, I want to talk about goals. And the little tidbit that I learned years ago, I wish I had acted on it when I first learned it. And that is to set goals that are definite and concrete and objective. Most people make the mistake of setting goals like, I want to lose weight, or I want to get stronger, or I want to look better. That's like going to an archery tournament and the official says, well, just fire your arrows out there and we'll decide later if you won or not. No, you need to set something that has a definite finish line, like I want to lose 10 pounds. And then you need to come up with a definite deadline, like I want to lose 10 pounds by the end of the year, or I want to gain 20 pounds of strength on my bench press by July 1st. All five of my goals that you heard in this episode, are they have that. They have a definite finish line and they have a definite deadline. I will know by 11:59 p.m. January 31st if I've made my goal or not. So that's my quick little piece of advice to you. If you've got vague goals, go home and change them now and get a good start on 2019 or whenever you see this video. Made it.